So the woman gave a book to the child.
Yes. Yosh, yosh, big onik.
The woman ate rice.
Tu ban ya no more.
Bun the cheek.
Tu ban ya mo pan de.
So do you think that's midterm?
No, we cannot use that one. That would be like use a copy of the English.
Because the question is, ¿quién le pegó? And then automatically you would say, le pegó su papá.
Yeah.
So we just use like a reflexive kind of passive. So that's why we use the pronoun ne, le.
But I should also state that we can give her a sentence in Spanish and she can produce a sentence in Huitepec, but that doesn't mean that's really the right translation. Mm-hmm. So we have to make sure that we keep an open mind about it. So it's something she can utter in the same context, but we're going to have to do our own analysis to figure out, is it, you know, what's the structure of it? Mm-hmm.
Y tiene de chique.
Last thing we transcribed the word really. Oh wait, no, that's what we had.
I think we had both of them.
Yes.
Like it was possibly with the A.
Yeah. Okay. So we had those transcriptions possible. Mm-hmm.
My word is debating a lot of different. When we had a lot of different two choice options last time. You're really super.
We just shaped me.
Yes.
So Marie's scream is the gloss, though.
I think this is British.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, but we just need to catch. You're right, actually. So we're getting a different word order here. Mm-hmm. Silverware.
Tu ban ya no more chocolate.
But yash is not spoke then it the chilzi.
Tu ban ya more tu minyo.
Yash, but
that's okay.